All right, let's get back over to Dave and talk about these cold temps. Are they sticking around for a bit?
Yeah, they are, Sheba. And as we are kind of talking about cold weather, usually that means the end of hurricane season is near, and we are 14 days left of the hurricane season. But man, it is dealing with kind of going out with a bang here. We do have a very powerful hurricane out there. We've had 30 now named storms, breaking the record of 05. We had 28, 13 hurricanes, now 6 major hurricanes on the season. You can see here the bigger picture does show we have Iota here, which is almost a category 5. And there's also another low kind of behind it here, following it, that does have a low chance of development at 30%, and that could impact Central America as we head to a little later on this week. But look at Iota here, just incredible looking hurricane here, the buzzsaw shape to it, wobbly eye with it. Likely we have circulations going on within the eye as well, kind of just passing near one of the islands here too, with potentially category 4 or 5 winds out there. Winds are at 155, moving west to 10, pressure down to 925 millibars, and you can see here it is working its way closer into Nicaragua, and it is expected to potentially get near at Cat 5. Cat 5 starts at 156, so we're almost there. And this is the forecast track from earlier this morning at 3 a.m. We'll get another update at 9 a.m., but you can see kind of working its way on in toward Nicaragua, Honduras area, and headed towards San Salvador, and it continues to weaken, of course, with the mountainous terrain there. Unlike Ada, which turned to the north, high pressure is going to sit north of this, so this is not expected to work its way northward. But you can see the water temperature is 84 degrees down there versus the 60s and 70s we have across the Gulf of Mexico. But you can see where Ada went, kind of dove down here a little bit, and look at the landfall within probably a few dozen miles a forecast of where Iota is going to be making landfall. So just going to be incredible to see how this plays out over the next couple of days. Devastating though, flooding rains 2-3 feet of rain expected out there, not to mention the surge in the wind here from a potentially category 5 hurricane. We have not had a category 5 this year. Remember 05, we had 3 category 5 hurricanes, so we've not had one yet, but we are pretty close. This is definitely the strongest hurricane so far this year with those winds of 155 miles per hour. So we'll be watching this as it makes landfall for tonight, but again, not a threat to our area.